Game number one, OG versus Fnatic. We are in the third series of today. Uh-oh, Jabs down bottom. Not sure if he didn't see the salve or what, but he went a bit too far, and that is going to be first blood, drawn by Seb. Bottom lane. Trying to keep the pressure on Jarex. Able to get over and steal away the bounty rune and takes down Jabs, but will lose his life for the cause. They're ready to take Roche. This is really hard to deal with now. Sleight of Fist. Maybe way to open it up to get some roots there on the no-tail, but the swap to pull him back in. The stun not going to connect as he was able to get the Remnant out of there. Down to the follow-up stun, the silence as well. Ahmed can't stay here. He's going to get caught by Jarex over to the side. The roll back, forth, and through. They have the Fiend's Grip, but it's not good enough, and DJ can only throw down the Midnight Pulse. But Fnatic just lost three. And Black Hole down bottom. They find the kill onto the Venge. So multiple kills across the map. Fnatic able to take down both of them as they get ready to contest for these bounty runes, and looking for more, they found themselves. The Drow Ranger does have that Aegis. All right, No Tail is back up in 5 seconds, but I don't know if he can get back here in time. So the rest of OG need to be able to keep Ana alive throughout this. Jarek's trying to go in for the roll. Can they make it work? They're going to roll through onto two, but Ahmed, he gets the blink away over to the other side, and that makes sure they get the kill onto Drow. He's under attack. But they do need to get back to the base because there's pressure coming. All the treants in the world, they pop the drums. Have the Dom creep there as well. Just the Siege one, and the slowdown comes onto Ana. That was immediately able to interrupt that grip. Really well played there by Ana to get the silence off first. And, well, Ice is in the middle of all of them, just trying to tank through all of this damage. Can't finally kill them off in time, or are OG going to destroy them all? They roll through. They find themselves another. Ahmed wants to get this kill desperately, but it is not happening. It looks like they are going to leave it with Tower, just 90 HP left. And they're instead trying to find Jabs, who's TP'd back behind enemy lines. The Nightstalker's coming into this one as well. Do you really want to fight into all of this? They get the three-man silence now, but it's a ton of damage coming out from the Enchantress. This position five looking more like a little bit of a three. Can they kill him off in time? Yes, they do, but the Black Hole comes out. It's going to be interrupted. Ana there to save the day. They make it happen. They do end up losing Thompson, but Fnatic lost damn near everybody else. Jarex is going to die to one more hit. Ahmed is very large into charge here, but a eventually, it's the Seb Ultra kill that ends it. 12-17, it might not matter because this game could be over before he even gets back. At 20 minutes, the swap comes in. They're able to find him already. There's no Dark Ascension. It's daytime. Venge might end up going down, though. Thompson is going to fall, but they still have that illusion, giving the Vengeance aura. Probably one of the better heroes that could have died at this point, as OG just want to keep this pressure onto the building. They're keeping the illusion alive. They're even using the urn on it to try and keep it up. And was able to find the kill before Thompson could jump over the top of the cliff. Ana now in a little bit of trouble. He doesn't have TPs, but he has the rest of his team nearby. I don't know if this is a fight that OG really want to take, though. The Dark Ascension comes out. They've already found the silence onto two. The silence comes for the turnaround coming from Ana. The Black Hole, it's connecting, but it's not nearly enough. DJ was not able to find the Drow yet again. Swap back pulls him out of position, and now Ana is free to just lay waste to all of them. They do find that secondary kill, but OG have lost four. They're going in, though. Ice. I mean, this feels like this fight is... Oh, God, Ahmed. He gets the blink out of the Sprout, though. It's going to keep him alive for the moment. Root, Chase, DJ looking for an opening, but he's getting his blink canceled. Still trying to find Seb. Seb, he doesn't do anything. The BKB, it comes out the Black Hole. Is it going to be enough? They're doing a lot of damage to these guys with DJ in the midst of an MP there as well. They burn through the Aegis, but now Drow is coming back a second round. They had a buyback on the Bane, although they're still keeping this Nightstalker alive. It looks like OG are finally going to do it. They pull back in Ice, and focus the tower.
Yeah, it feels like this is the game. GG's call. Fly Fnatic.
Nonetheless, we do have the final picks here. Ahmed gonna play on the puck. Thompson Invoker.
Oh, they're gonna block him. Body block him to death.
Oh God, he doesn't have anywhere left to go. No tail. Oh man, that's unfortunate. And Ana is gonna try and make something of it. Seeing the extra damage they can do. Still a little ways away from that level two from No Tail. They need to kill a couple more creeps to make it work, but they still might be able to find the kill nonetheless. Fairy Fire was not enough to keep Ice alive, so... Oh, the tornado to interrupt, so he can't jump to his creep, but now the cold snap as well. Ahmed wanting to run, he's taking some tower shots. Waning Rift could come out in a second, and... gets the kill, gets out. On the other side, we did see the Nature's Prophet go down as well. Yep, movement in, coming in, trying to take down Ana there, and he is gonna get stunned, gets killed. Bottom lane also, MP got completely zoned out by Seb. Thompson doesn't have a way out of that one. They dropped the sentry ward, they were ready. And at least Jerix is gonna be here to try and get some counter push play coming. And Abed, he actually used the orb phase shift, not just the stun.
And if he's got a mid lane.
Oh my god, this is huge. If they can kill Seb. The silence, it's so much damage. He is going to get those rotations in, though. That keeps him alive. And they actually had level 6 now on the Batrider, pulling in the puck. Do you have the Reaper's Scythe to find the kill? There is some pretty nice little all chat banters going on as well. That was costly coming from the Necrophos into. You might wish to retract that from the puck. Oh. They also are going to use this in the mid lane. The Haunt up top trying to find this kill onto Ana, completely isolated. They throw out that tornado to try and interrupt Ana, doing whatever damage he can. Finds one kill, trying to escape, but Ana is going to drop. So it's a 2-for-1 exchange so far. And they're also going to find themselves Mr. No-Tail, but no more stun to throw out there to try and interrupt. And Thompson moving into position. They're going to have a Reaper Scythe in 25 seconds. 40 seconds for MP to have Haunt back up again. Well, they don't even need it. They're just going to jump on him. Jerix with the Inkswell, but Dark Willow in position.
Worth it.
Aww, you thought you were winning.
After we're going to that Shadow Realm, but the dive down bottom. They take down the Nature's Prophet. Abed in position has already used Coil, though, so can't really get the best of follow-up. Seb doesn't have Reaper Scythe for another 30 seconds, but now they're maybe in a bit too deep, and they find themselves this Necrophos with nothing left in the tank. They're going to be able to chase him down. Tries to make this play here. He does have stick charges back up again in a little while. They want to burst him before he can get the Reaper Scythe off, and they will. And now the two-person Sprout, they find Ana and Thompson with this one. Fnatic streaming forward and able to take down another kill. A good tornado with the ice hole afterwards and the silence. Abed trying to get that kill. Can they get him? No. Ana gets out, and it looks like Thompson might also get out as well. He gets the stun. No more Ghost Walk. Fight me is the call, but that will be a dead Invoker. But still. Seb trying to get the burn down, the coil, and meanwhile it's going to wrap on all of them. They're going to be able to find the snap. The combo was there and it was beautiful, but Seb heals back up afterwards, and Ana just trying to lay into all of them. The double Reaper Scythe. Oh, he's got a twin and he is scary. But the Wraith King is able to live through this one, and they do burn through that Aegis, but still, it's the Spectre gone for so long now. And Wraith King getting slowed up, he might just end up going down here. Pops the stick charges, tries to run, tries to get out of there. But he does not have a second ulti. Unlike that Necrophos with the Grimstroke combo. My god. Unreal. Well, this is very similar to what we saw before. OG lose one, but they're still willing to sit in with three. The Nath of Nature comes out. They bring down the Grimstroke, actually, and Thompson again interrupting there with the tornado. They're going to be able to lasso back in jabs, but Ana, standing tall, takes down all of the rest of them. Even these illusions aren't doing enough. OG don't give a damn. They're just running at them. They are finally going to back up. And they're just looking. They just want to run into them. And they do find Thompson stunned. The tornado, it missed. Oh, the fear comes out afterwards. The slowdown, it comes. Can they kill him off in time? Thompson trying to get out, but it's not going to happen. Ana, though, has his eyes on this Wraith King. Wants to bring him down, but they do have the Wraith King ulti. A second round coming out as MP tries to chase forward for this Drow Ranger. Seeing if they can play a little bit of interference. A good combo there. The TP away from Ana. Does he get out in time? No. Yule's Scepter lift up. No-Till on the other side's caught. And Jabs has the catch now onto Ana with the stunning coming out. Three dead from OG. Fnatic strike back. Wards that are played down deep in enemy territory, and they see that Thompson was there with that Observer Ward. They find him, Deafening Blast to try and keep him alive, but they're gonna run this man down. His Invoker is going to drop.
Turning off the Radiance. That attack. Offensive. Aura. Tail.
They found no tail. Ana, he's in the middle of him though. The Blade Mail, it's coming out. Ana can't hit him anymore. Now MP is on top with that Diffusal Blade, trying to find the kill. The Yule Scepter combo comes out from DJ. Terrorize afterwards. It connects onto all three of them. They're in the coil as well. He's gonna drop as they find that kill onto Ana. He goes down, but now the Grimstroke, the turnaround. Do they have it? The double Reaper Scythe. It's enough to kill one, but not the other. No Spectre for 100 seconds. No buyback either. Wraith King is gonna go down in this Radiance. Actually, not being up means that no tail will live through the first salvo of it, but they do find themselves the second secondary kill. The tornado, rather meteor, coming down and landing onto his head. Seb, can he get out of there in time? He's just barely able to walk away, and they can't find that kill. Dagon, everything, the whole kit and caboodle, but they do finally find him. Abed manages to get that kill. Silence afterwards jaunts back. Abed trying to escape, has a Yule Scepter, and we'll have a blink in a second. Gets the phase shift, and now the jump away, has a coil as well. But Abed played his way out of it. Oh, down bottom. Just when it happens and it looks good, Jerex walks up a hill and finds a greeting party there. The Haunt comes out afterwards. Who are they going to find? Ana, they jump onto him, jumping back and forth. The stun comes out. The Gust afterwards, trying to escape now. The rest of his team left him behind. The Glimmer Cape, though, is going to be enough to keep him alive, and the fear pushes that Necrophos away. He's the main key to killing off the Spectre. Maybe they just punch him to death.
They had a
unreal. Well, they find themselves two kills, and it's a long time before the Spectre or the Puck are going to be back in this game, and... Oh, the cold snap also. Tornado coming in from downtown finds the Wraith King, and they have Reaper Scythe up again. They find their man. They are going to have him for the second life, a second time. Blade Mill actually is bought by the Spectre while he's dead, but that is a dead Wraith King. He does have buyback, but so much damage on this tier 4, and they can't wait for the Wraith King. They have to buy back on him, but they're going to try and time it with the Dark Willow being back up and alive as well. The buyback now on the Wraith King, gonna throw out the dagger, connects onto Ana. Chase 4, Yule Scepter lift up. There is no BKB right now on Ana, but they need to be able to take her down and deal with the Aegis afterwards. So much damage coming out with that Dagon. And now they're trying to isolate Jerex, see if they can find that kill. It's actually gonna be a catch onto an illusion here, and the Blade Mill is already out. It's gonna be a lot of damage, but it is gonna be a dead Spectre. 2 minutes, Wraith King's coming back in a second. The Fear again comboing together with the Coil, but it's not nearly enough damage. OG are just running away from them and then killing them off afterwards. Topson gets the jump away. Do they have the Dagon kill? It looks like they'll probably take down Topson down there to the south. But the bigger problem is gonna be everybody else. Well, OG come in and take down Fnatic, who came in third at the last tournament that they attended, which was the DreamHack event. And you start to wonder, are they fully back online? This team came in and completely dismantled Fnatic.